there are really only three things you can do when it comes to hair color. You can lighten it, you can darken, and you can tone. Toning, in essence, is not intended to lighten or darken the hair at all, but simply enhance or correct the tone. Hi, I'm Shannon. I've been in the industry since 2008. I've worked as a hair color educator with Redken Fifth Avenue, and along with being licensed, I also hold an applied science degree in cosmetology. And today, I'm going to use all of that to simplify an otherwise elusive topic. Arguably the most overlooked factor in toning is the level system. The right level on the wrong tone or the wrong level on the right tone can both be catastrophic. The level system is simply a gradient scale with the darkest on the bottom and the lightest at the top. There is not one universal level system. Every hair color company out there can place their levels anywhere they want to along this scale. Some brands may choose to do the traditional 10, others may cram 12 into the scale. They can have them evenly spaced, or they can concentrate more options in the lighter half and less in the darker half, or vice versa. This means that if I took 100 swatches of level 9s from 100 different companies, they would not all look the same, which is why it's really important that you identify your level according to that company before you use their hair color. If you are a level 8 in brand A, you may be considered a level 9 in brand B. So if you're used to grabbing a level 8 and decide to switch it up and grab a level 8 from brand B, in this scenario, you're gonna end up darker than you planned. So let's see what happens when we have the correct level of light violet and place it over light yellow. Works beautifully, counteracts just as it's supposed to, but if I were to try and put that light level of violet over a darker level, maybe even like a darker orange, it's simply not gonna have any impact. I see this all the time with at-home toning, level 7s trying to tone themselves with level 9s and wondering why it's not working. On the flip side of that, if your level is too dark, it's not only going to counteract the tone that you're trying to neutralize, it's going to completely overpower it and be all that you see. So now that we know how level is just as crucial as tone, let's talk about tone a little bit more. I think we all know that opposite sides of the color wheel counteract each other, but let's talk about that principle a little more in depth. So what is neutral? Is it tan? Is it gray? This is determined by your ratio or strength of your primaries in the colors at play. In beauty school, we are taught that to create a balanced tan, you need one part blue, two parts red, and three parts yellow. And to create a completely toneless shade, a gray instead of a tan, you would need equal parts of these primaries. Here's a little bit of advanced color theory for you. Each color has a place in this world where it is its most brilliant, its most vibrant. For blues, it is when they are deep and saturated. When you start to lighten the blue, it loses that intensity. For reds, they are happiest kind of in the middle. When you start to darken or lighten them too much, they lose their vibrancy. And yellows are at their most brilliant when they are light and bright. You don't see too many dark yellows that are rich and saturated. So this equal parts ratio and 1-2-3 ratio works with primaries on the same line, on the same level. When you start to mix a dark yellow with a light blue and a red somewhere in between, it's not gonna be as reliable. So this principle applies to primary colors at the same level of intensity. But we don't mix up our hair color with primary colors, so how does this apply to us? You're right, we don't, but the formulators behind the brands that we use do, which is why it is so important to know your brand inside and out. If you're a professional watching this, study your brand swatch books, take their formulation classes. If you are at home going about this on your own, you may have to invest in several different toners and do test strands on yourself to find what's gonna work for you. Same goes for things like purple shampoo too. One brand may have a truer violet where it will simply just neutralize the yellow, and another brand may have a bluer violet where it's gonna completely tone out that yellow and create more of a grayer shade. Now let's see what happens when we have the right level but the wrong tone. So we'll use that yellow, orange, violet example from earlier. So we know that the light level violet did not have any effect on the darker level orange, but what if we darken the level of violet? Well, it definitely changed it, but now you have rose gold. Let's talk about why that happened. Well, we know that orange is a mix of red and yellow, so the only primary we need to balance it is the blue. And we gave it violet, which has blue, but it also has an extra dose of red, which is what we end up seeing. We simply need to take out that extra red and move our toner from violet to blue, and it'll work perfectly. So what if you have a mix of orange and yellow in your hair? What toner do you use then? I see this a lot, especially with balayage, where it's the lightest on the ends and it can tend to be a little darker and warmer towards the middle as it fades. Here's the approach I would recommend. Formulate your toner for the lightest parts of your hair. Go ahead and tone it, and those lighter parts will be beautiful, and those darker parts are gonna stick out like a sore thumb. But you can use this to your advantage. Now you can formulate a toner for those darker parts and be able to apply it really precisely just where you need it. This is not the quicker way of doing it. You can most certainly mix up two toners from the get-go, one for the orange and one for the yellow, but it's definitely the most fail-proof way. Sometimes when you have two toners going at once, you can accidentally get the darker toner on the lighter parts and it'll overtone, or you can get the lighter toner on the darker parts and it won't affect it at all. It's just not as safe. Sometimes it's hard to tell that there are different levels going on, especially if they're the same tone. You can have a really light level of yellow and a darker level of yellow and not really know it until you put that toner on. The lighter parts are gonna pick it up beautifully, and the darker parts are still gonna be there. That's okay, it's no big deal. You just mix up another formula that's a little bit darker and apply it where you need it. Keep in mind that toner can sometimes make you feel darker. Warm colors reflect more light. It's just in their nature. So when you remove all of that reflection, you lose that light and you feel darker. This is especially true in the orange and red shades. You may not realize how dark of a level you really need to be able to cover those shades. Here's an example. I have two pictures of the same red hair color. I've just placed a green toning filter over the bottom. The lighter picture appears lighter because it's brighter and it has that warmth and reflection, but it's actually not any lighter at all. In fact, take out your phone, swipe to the monochromatic filter on your camera, and hold it over this picture. You will see that neither the top or the bottom photo is lighter or darker than the other. They're the same level. The bottom photo is simply missing that warmth and reflection. So if you have a client saying that they're over the red and they want the red out, then definitely explain to them that they might feel darker without all of that warmth. I actually have an older video demonstrating one of my favorite methods to use on a brunette that constantly turns brassy as they fade, and I will link that down below. So can anything be used as a toner, or does it have to explicitly say toner on the bottle? Yeah, anything can be used as a toner. If you are using it for the sole intention of not lightening or darkening, but just affecting the tone, it's a toner. Still, it's important to know why you're choosing what you're choosing, and we're gonna talk about that right now. First line of defense is your temporary toners. These are like your purple shampoos and typically only last one wash. Some vocabulary you'll wanna keep in mind. These toners are deposit only, which means they only add in color. They don't remove any color from your hair. They are direct dyes and non-oxidative dyes, which means what you see is what you get. You don't need a developer in order for them to change from one color into another. It's just straight out of the tube. There you go. You would choose temporary toners for subtle changes or maintenance. Next up is semi-permanent toners. These are also non-oxidative direct dyes, which those two terms can be used interchangeably, and they are also deposit only. The only difference between semi-permanent colors compared to temporary colors is that the semi-permanent dyes, the dye molecules are quite a bit smaller, so they're able to get farther into the hair strand, which means they last longer. They can last anywhere from 2 to 6 weeks, depending on the shade. Lighter shades will fade off faster, and darker shades tend to stick around a little bit longer. The majority of the time, though, the toner of choice is demi-permanent colors. The only difference between demi-permanent and permanent is the alkalinity and the amount of ammonia or monoethanolamine in the hair color. Monoethanolamine is an ammonia substitute. It does the exact same job as ammonia and sometimes referred to as MEA. Demi-permanent colors require a developer because they are either a mix of direct dyes and oxidative dyes, which oxidative dyes are clear colorless molecules and require a developing catalyst to turn them into the color that they're supposed to be. So they can either be a mix of these two types of dyes or fully oxidative dyes. If you pour your toner out of the bottle or squeeze it out of the tube and it already has a tint to it, this just means that there may be direct dyes present in the formula. Or it could also mean that your toner is old or you left the cap off and it started to oxidize just from the oxygen in the air. If you pour your toner out of the bottle or squeeze it out of the tube and it is clear, this just means that it is a fully oxidative toner. Demi-permanent hair colors are also intended to deposit only. I say intended to because there are some brands with higher alkalinity or higher amounts of ammonia or MEA in them that can lighten certain hair types. So if you have very fine hair or over-processed hair, this may come up for you. Most demi-permanent hair colors have very minuscule amounts of these ingredients, but it does happen and I have seen it. All demi-permanent hair colors have some little bit of ammonia or MEA in them, simply to keep those dyes stable until they come in contact with the developer. The developer used in demi-permanent hair colors is usually very low. Developer is an oxidizing catalyst. It is H2O2 hydrogen peroxide, which is basically just oxygenated water. And then you have permanent hair color, which can be used as a toner in a very specific circumstance. Permanent hair color requires a developer because it contains oxidative dyes and it deposits and lifts, which means lightens. Permanent hair color now does have sufficient amounts of ammonia or monoethanolamine to be able to effectively lighten natural hair. I have a video going really in depth about this process on a molecular level. It's really interesting. I'll link it down below for you. Highly recommend it. Using permanent hair color as a toner can be a bad thing if you don't intend to lighten your natural hair. So imagine you have your natural root color and then a beautiful balayage on the ends, and you could have even formulated your toner perfectly for the bottom, right level, right tone. But if you used a permanent hair color, now your natural hair is orange because it started to lighten. I see this all the time with at-home toners. For reference, the Wella toner is a permanent toner. I'm only saying that because I know it's a really popular choice. The only time I use permanent hair color as a toner is when there is no natural hair color left. So either a mix of artificial dye with lightened hair, because you can only lighten artificial dye with lightener, because in that case you can throw the permanent hair color over everything and it's not going to affect that artificial dye. Or the other time I will use it is when it is a global application of lightener, root to ends, everything lifted out. But the only reason I would choose permanent hair color over demi-permanent is if I still wanted to try and lift out a little bit of that remaining natural pigment. For example, if you have lightened yourself all over to a level 9, but your goal was maybe a nice bright level 10, then in that situation, it is probably safer to try and lift it that one extra level with a permanent hair color rather than going back in with another round of bleach. If you're trying to lighten more than just one or two levels though, you probably will still have to go in with lightener. Lightener is a fancy name for bleach. This is where it gets a little complicated though, because you have to formulate your permanent hair color to tone at your desired level, your target level. So you don't want to formulate it for the level 9 that you're currently at, you want to formulate it for the level 10 that you're hoping to get to. Also keep in mind that this method works best on freshly lightened hair. If you had your hair lightened several weeks ago, you had a toner put on it, but now it's faded away and you want to try and lift it out with permanent hair color, it's probably not going to be as reliable, just because of the presence of those artificial dyes, even if it's minuscule amounts. That was a lot to unpack. I want to do a Q&A following up with any questions you have on this video, so leave those down below for me. I'd also love to know what your biggest takeaway was, and I'm going to leave the two videos I mentioned earlier right here that you can click on to watch, and click right here to subscribe.